he's been better, I believe, with each and every game that passes by. He has such tremendous offensive skills and really gets involved in the play and jumps up and creates offense. He's got the good shot, so the Islanders miss him tonight.
And Finley a little after Gallagher there after that pop-up resulted in Finley getting the worst of that.
Yeah, you look at it was Desharnais or White, I believe, and just kind of bowled him over a little bit. And Finley,
with the way that they played, and it worked. Sometimes you might lose that the next year. I just don't think that's been the case at all. The team's really responded, haven't they?
Really have. A big hit on Laddie Schmid is knocked over the boards in Montreal Bay.
Too little, too late. You know, this kind of intensity, the energy that was lacking in the Montreal game, it's not going to do much at this point. Laddie Schmid getting knocked over there as Desharnais finishes his check.
Almost dances his way to the goal, but is taken away. Now stepping up his ass, what a hit! On Lindholm out near center ice.
Ends up turning the puck over, and as the Ducks start coming out of the zone, look at this, Lindholm carrying the puck. Tarantis with a big shoulder just drops him.
Absolutely a great hit by Tarantis, who kind of levels up a little bit, but when you're the height disadvantage that Tarantis has, it's not going to be called by the player's safety, that's for sure.
The boy get ahead of steam, but couldn't turn into the middle and get a shot away. Back to the line, dribbling puck, and it's deflected one. Meantime, Josh Georges.
They're both very good defensive teams, and when they get the chance, they'll take you out physically. That Francis Bouillon, he's not very big. Good solid hit on Boyd Gordon.
We saw that from the LensCrafter RoboCam.
Tenby able to pick this up. Nice job by Cam Jansen to stay on side.
LDS.
Uncatchable pass. There's no interference on the play. Sobotka goes head over heels as Krug cocks the hip and sends him flying.
Pasternak after it again, but had it taken away by Emily. And it's cleared off the glass by Lekkinen up ahead for Shaw. And Shaw gets cranked by Tori Krug. And Shaw is slow to get to his feet. Here's Krejci with a drive, stopped by Price. He'll hold on. And Shaw needs a little bit of attention when he arrives at the Canadiens bench.
This puck comes off the boards. Shaw probably doesn't expect a guy like Tori Krug, a little bit of a smaller defenseman. He comes in and steps right into Andrew Shaw. And Shaw gets caught lean, and that's shoulder right in the face slash head of Shaw. And here's hoping that Andrew Shaw is going to be okay.
And Gerby now back in his own zone. A heavy hit on Franz Nielsen.
Riley Nash looking for Vetrano. Vetrano's forward move. Dominic Moore goes for a tumble over Matt Zuccarello as the little Norwegian gets his hip right in the way. Dominic Moore with a little gymnastic move here off the hip check.
He's a pretty elusive guy. He's able to dance around a lot of people, especially when it's at that chip and chase or a self pass, but Zuccarello slows down just enough and he gets the hip in a real good spot as Moore tries to jump by him. Kevin Miller came over.
Hoffman with a loose puck at center ice, a hit for Turris. Goes leaping around Zuccarello, who sends him flying.
Turris is going right down the tunnel here for the Senators. He's gone right off the bench. Here's Kyle Turris gets hit by Matt Zuccarello. Watch when Turris goes to the ice. He's going to land right on his hand. You see him holding his right hand against his body. As he spins and you see the first thing that lands is his right hand and arm. Fortunately for the Senators, after a brief time away, Turris comes back to the bench.
Ryder gets the shot away and a save by Nabokov. Henrique with a hit in the offensive zone. He levels Hickey.
The shield on, he just shanked the shot, missed it completely. There's a beautiful read by Steven Gionta, wipe out Hickey. And that resulted in the chance.
Could have cheated and maybe came off that post and given up a short side goal like he did the last game. Ellerby plays this across. Florida in the middle of a change and a big hit delivered on Smithson. You get the license
plate? Yes, Steven Gionta.
Wow, what an inspiration he's been since being called up. Now it's my turn. He finds Smith in the neutral zone.
Not his fault. He just shoots hard. That is a plus. You have somebody that does that. Meanwhile,
Barkowski just got run right into the double bench. On the left part of your screen, Matt Barkowski is going to go up the ice. Now watch Steven Gianta. Right over the boards and into the bench.
That's a little Ohio State taking it from Boston College.
Play a 3-3 tie and 2-2. Makes his presence felt.
Suter a shot, that one blocked, goes after the rebound. Pulled away and fed out left wing side. And 2-2 just absolutely leveled there. Bobby for a leak, and now we have a pileup, I guess fittingly enough, in the referee's crease.
And Brian McCabe took exception to that in a hurry, Pete.
The fans just saw the replay, by the way, on the Megatron here.
And again, Pete, it's a solid check, and it was an open ice check. It was shoulder to shoulder on that hit.
Patrick Ease with a shot, playing his second game in 14 months. Big hit! 2-2 with a crash there on Philip Larson.
Yeah, this is not time this time. The kid doesn't like it.
Brennan Dillon wanted to come.
Not long ago, this would have been charging, but boy, oh boy.
Well, how about for Larson? Every shift he goes on after.